solved model paper SSC public examination April 2023 social studies paper 1 and 2. This is the model question paper released by SCERT Andhra Pradesh Amaravathi. This model question paper contains 8 pages. 21E and 22E is the question paper code. Time duration 3 hours. Maximum marks 100. All answers shall be written in the answer booklet only. Government is going to provide you 124 pages booklet. You have to answer all the questions in the booklet itself. Question paper consists of 4 sections and 33 questions. There will be 33 questions in 4 sections. Internal choice is available in section 4 only. Answers shall be written neatly and legibly. Now we see section 1. What is given in one? Section 1, there will be 12 questions of objective type questions. Each question carries 1 mark. The nature of questions: define, expand or full forms, find the odd man out, arrange from south to north or west to east, ascending order according to the event took place, pictures, logos, emblems, map related questions, draw a bar graph or pie graph, find the correct answer, fill in the blanks, match the following. Like that questions will be asked in section 1. The answer of questions may be either in one word or in one sentence. That is called objective type questions. So question number 1, what are called dunes? Is the definition asked here. Call center, employee, service sector, fisherman, desk, relationship between first and second, same repeat with third and fourth. Expand AGW. What is meant by sex ratio definition given here? Mention the most common reason for male and female migrants. Here one slogan is given: we will drone but we will not move. So this is a slogan given. Like that, in 8th question, match the agent orange with one of the following. So A, B, C are given, one will be right from it. Question number 10, an emblem is given. So this is asked, which international organization is connected with this given logo. Question number 11, plot the below information on a bar graph. That means taking into consideration this table, we have to draw a rough bar graph. Question number 12, arrange the following from west to east. So countries of world are given. You have to see which country lies in the west, which country lies in the east, and which are in between of it. This is about section 1. Now we come to section 2. There will be 8 questions and each question carries 2 marks. These are very short answer questions. That means answer of these questions may be in 1 or 2 sentences. Question number 13 to question number 20 are of 2 mark questions. Up to question number 20. Now come to section 3. There will be 8 questions and each question carries 4 marks. Each question carries 4 marks. 4 into 8, 32 marks. These are short answer questions. Answer of each question should be 4 sentences to 8 sentences. Question number 21 to question number 28 are up for 4 mark questions. Here one graph is given, question asked it. Map is also given. Now come to section number 4. In section number 4, there will be 5 questions and each question carries 8 marks. 5 into 8, 40 marks. In this section only, you will find internal choice questions. That means in either A or B option you have to answer. If you know the both, you can write one as a regular, one for choice, that is up to you. Now, in this section, last question, that is a 33 question, is related to map pointing, where you have to answer 33A as well as 33B, because in 33A you have to locate this group A or B in India map, and 33B you have to locate either group A or group B in world map. This is the, that means India map as well as world map, each and every student have to point out. Now we see the booklet supplied by the government of Andhra Pradesh. This is the model booklet, which carries 24 pages. Here full signature of the invigilator, serial number will be printed before giving to you. Andhra Pradesh 10th class public examination model answer booklet, subject source studies, paper 1 and 2. So there are some certain instructions for the students you have to go through once. Then from page number 2 onwards, you have to write the answers from page number 2. See here given 2 by JP. JP is code of this booklet. Now after page number 2, now you have to go for page number 3. Like that, page number 4, page number 5, and so on. Very, very important thing is you have to answer the questions whatever you knows very well. So if you write the questions what you know very well at the beginning, that will create an impression with the examiner. While correcting, the examiner should feel that he is a good student. Now we go for the first question. What are called dunes? From chapter 1, the valleys lying between the Lesser Himalayas and Shivalik range are called as dunes. Example, Dehradun, Patli Dun, Kotli Dun are some of the prominent dunes. See, the important point in this answer I underlined. You can underline it with pencil or with a blue pen, which will attract the eye of the examiner. Second question, call center employee belongs to service sector. Fisherman belongs to DAS, that means fisherman belongs to agriculture or private sector. Expand AGW. AGW means anthropogenic global warming. Question number 4, what is meant by sex ratio? From chapter 6, sex ratio is the number of females per 1000 males in the population. This was underlined here. See, number of females per 1000 males in the population. According to 2011 census, sex ratio of India is 943 females per 1000 males. Mention the most common reason for males and females to migrate. From chapter 8, marriage is the most common reason for female migration, whereas employment or seeking employment is the most common reason for male migration. This is the answer of it. Question number 6, we will drone but we will not move. Who wrote these words and to whom? From chapter 12. Baba Mahalia wrote these words to the then Chief Minister of Madhya Pradesh, Digvijay Singh. Question number 7. What is the name of last Tsar of Russia? From chapter 14. Last Tsar of Russia was Nicholas II. Question 8. Match the Agent Orange with one of the following. From chapter 15. Plant killer, silent spring, Chipko movement. Agent Orange is a plant killer. 9. Who succeeded Jawaharlal Nehru as Prime Minister? From chapter 18. Lal Bahadur Shastri succeeded Jawaharlal Nehru as Prime Minister of India. Question number 10. Which international organization is connected with the given logo? This is a logo of one of the international organization, that is emblem of United Nations organization. Question 11. Plot the below information on a bar graph. Chapter 18. Seat share in 1952 elections. Indian National Congress 364. People's Democratic Front 38 only. So this is the answer. This bar of Indian National Congress 364. This bar of PDF, that is 38 seats only. Question number 12. arrange the following from west to east. This is the world map, and here at the west you find first Austria, then India, then China, then Japan. That means from west to east, Austria, India, China and Japan is the right answer of it. Section 2, each question carries 2 marks. What is site in view of settlement from chapter 7? Site refers to the characteristics of the place, its topography, altitude, water characteristics, that means the place with lake, rivers, underground waters, type of soil, security, shelter from natural forces and so on. Question number 14. Comment on the condition of small farmers in India. This is from chapter 9. Farmers who own less than 2 hectares of land are known as small farmers. Cultivation of such plot does not bring adequate income to the farmer family. Small farmers face so many problems. After working on his own field, he has to work as a laborer in the fields of some big farmers for a petty amount of rupees 100 to 200 per day. Being a small farmer, he does not have any equipment or working capital. Question number 15. Based on the information given below, write your observation. It is from chapter 3. What we observe from here? Employment in various sectors, that is agriculture, industry and service sector. Years are given 1972-73, 2009 and 2010. Here what we observe is, first of all, my observation. In my observation, employment in agriculture sector is decreasing. See here, employment in agriculture, it was 74 in 72-73 and came down to 53 in 2009 and 10. Employment in industry and service sector growing. Industry and service sector growing, that means from 11 to 22 and from 15 to 25 it is increasing. Industry sector doubled the employment, whereas service it grows from 15% to 25%. That means the industry, so it was 11 in 72-73 become 22 in 9-10. That means it become double. Come to service, so it was 15% in 72-73, it become 25. That means there is a improvement in service sector. Anyhow, it is a mark of development. Question number 16. Observe the given map. Name any 4 states in which migration takes place from chapter 8. So this is the Indian map. You can see the arrow marks from states where the people are migrating. Here Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, people are migrating from their one state to other states. Here Madhya Pradesh to Uttar Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh to Rajasthan, Bihar to Delhi, Uttar Pradesh to Delhi, Uttarakhand to Delhi and so on. Question number 17. Write any 2 benefits of Lok Adalat. It is from 22, chapter 22. The Lok Adalat settle disputes in an amicable atmosphere by mutual consents in the presence of legal experts, officials and non-official dignitaries. That means disputes are settled amicably. Second, Lok Adalat settled long pending court cases in short time and without any expenses. That is a very, very important point here. Question number 18. What is meant by coalition government from chapter 19? Government formed by temporary alliance of the parties is called a coalition government. The first coalition government led by V.P. Singh's Janata Dal. Question number 19. How many states and union territories are there in India today from chapter 1? There are 28 states and 8 union territories are there in India at present. Question number 20. Appreciate the Meera Paivi movement. It is from chapter 21. Meera Paivi in Meitei language means torch bearers. Meera Paivi movement prevented alcoholic abuse in 1970s. Meera Paivi became a movement for human rights in 1980s. Mirapai women took to patrolling the streets at night. They fought against AFSPA. The women effort in this movement for human rights is appreciable. Section 3, each question carries 4 marks. Total 8 questions in 4 years, 32 marks. These are the short answer questions. Explain environmental sink function and sink source function and sink function. It is from chapter 12. The potential of environment to provide resources is referred to as an environmental source function. The sink function describes an environmental's ability to observe and render harmless waste and pollution. So, these are the two functions of environment. Question 22. Why are people migrating from rural area to urban area? This is from chapter 8. The migration from rural to urban area is very common. This is known as urbanization. They migrate permanent settlement. They mostly settle in unorganized sector. Reasons are employment, education, job, better life, better wage, availability of all facilities, etc. Question number 23. Write your observation from the given graph. From chapter 6. Fertility rate in India in 1961-2011. In 1961, what we observe? 5.9. 2011 2.7. So total birth per woman is given here. The my observation is the fertility rate for India in 1960 was more than 5.6, which indicates that on an average each woman was likely to bear 5 to 6 children. Second, the family decide the number of children they want depending on security, opportunity for children and social norms. Third, present fertility rate in India is 2.7. That means the trend is decreasing slowly. It is my observation. Question 24. Explain the uses of public distribution system from chapter 11. Public distribution system ensures better food security. The poor people cannot purchase the goods at market price. So, the government should provide such items to the poor. Rice, kerosene, sugar and oil is provided by the public distribution system. Through PDS, they can purchase the items at cheap rates. Question 25th. What are the immediate causes of First and Second World War? From chapter 13. The immediate cause for World War I was the murder of on 28th June 1914 of Ferdinando of Austria by Bosnian Serb. The immediate cause for World War II was the Germans tank driving into Poland on September 1st, 1939. Question 26. What were the difficulties faced in the conduct of first general elections in India from chapter 18? First one is, the first election were difficult because of social dimensions. A large section of people did not know how to read and write. In some part of country, women were known by their father's or husband's name. They did not have an independent identity. To overcome the problem of illiteracy, the election commission came up with a novel idea of having symbol from everyday life to represent political parties and candidates. Question number 27. Observe the given map and answer the questions. This from chapter 15. Who occupied more region? Name the river in the map. So, we find Hausa, Fulani, Yoruba, Igbo tribes. Three types of tribes are in Nigeria. Here, the answer is Hausa, Fulani people occupied more region. Second, river Niger is flowing in the Nigeria. Question 28. The 20th century is called Age of Extremes. Why? From chapter 13. Politically, the world saw suit of democratic aspirations grow amidst the rise of fascist domination. literacy level and average life expectancy grow immensely for all. New forms of art like movie emerged. Scientific knowledge rose to new heights. Women gained the right to vote. Enormous human loss in the world wars. Thus, the historian Eric Hobsbawm called 20th century as the age of extremes. Now come to section 4. There will be 5 questions. Each question carries 8 marks. In this section, you will find internal choice. Here, 29A. What are the difference between eastern coastal plains and western coastal plains from chapter 1? The difference we see. Eastern coastal plain is between the Bay of Bengal in the east and Eastern Ghat to the west. Come to western coastal plain. Western coastal plain is between the Arabian Sea and Western Ghats. 2. Wide deltas are formed by large rivers on the eastern coast. The other side, no deltas are formed in the western coast because of small rivers. 3. Eastern coastal plain is fertile due to alluvial soil. In western coast, too, except for the southern part, it is Malabar coast. Western coast plain is infertile for agriculture purpose. Eastern coast plains are broader. Western coast plains are very narrow. Eastern coastal plain is a level surface. Western coastal plain is intersected by mountain ridges. Eastern coastal plain is divided into two stretches, north and south. The part which is in the south is known as Coromandel coast, and the northern stretch of eastern coast is known as the Northern Circle. Western coastal plain are divided into 3 different sections. Southern part is Malabar coast, central part is Kanara coast, and the northern part is the Konkan coast. Question number 29B. In what ways was the emergency period a setback to Indian democracy? It is from chapter 18. The government adopted a series of repressive measures to bring back law and order of the country. Second, there was a violation of human rights and the fundamental rights were suspended. Third, there were instances of arbitrary detention and torture. Four, a large number of political leaders who opposed Indira Gandhi were put in jail and press censorship. 5. Fourth, sterilization brought discontent among the people of country. 6. Most importantly, the 42nd Constitutional Amendment, which brought a series of changes, weakened the democratic fabric of the country. 7. In the absence of civil liberties, people were nothing but helpless. 8. General elections were postponed. 9. The press was censored. 10. Indira Gandhi granted herself extraordinary powers. 11. Thus, the emergency period was set back to the Indian democracy. Question number 30A. Explain about the impact of globalization on India. Chapter 10. It is from chapter 10. Globalization describes a process by which regional economies, societies, and cultures have become integrated through a global network of communication, transportation, and trade. Impact of globalization in India are given here. These are the important: improved the productivity and efficiency, increase in foreign investment, enjoy a wider range of goods and services, increase in foreign trade, increase in foreign investment, coming of new technology, increased employment, greater choice to Indian consumer. Question number 30B. Explain about the relationship between India and China. It is from chapter 20. Recognize the communist government of China. China is neighboring country of India. Mekong line at the border between India and China. China annexed Tibet in 1950. Tibetan escaped along with Dalai Lama and it took refuge in India. Claimed to Akasai Chin area in Ladakh. India and China signed the Panchasila Pact. China united India in 1962. Diplomatic relations between India and China are restored in 1976. 31A. Plot the information given in the following pie graph in a table and write your observation from chapter 3. These are the 4 pie diagrams given: 1972-73, 2008-2013, 2009-10. Here sectors are given. In my observation, first, the employment in industry and service sector growing gradually. Employment in the industry and service are growing. We can see from 11-20 to 15-25. Whereas agriculture sector losing its priority in both employment and percentage in GDP. When I come to agriculture, it is decreasing from 74-53, decreasing. Second, it is a sign of development because there is improvement in industry and service. The agriculture sector giving employment for 53% in 2009 and 10, but its share in GDP is only 17%. Even though large number of people are employed, but their income is very less. If employment shift happens from agriculture, industry and service sector, it help in development of the country. And the table of this pie chart. 31B. Observe the graph and answer the following questions. Here, since the constitution was adopted on 26 January 1950 till 2013, nearly 99 amendments were made. The first question is, how many amendments were made in till 2013? There are 99 amendments. In which decade more amendments were made? In which decade? 1971-80. And 81-90, in these two times 22-22. In which year did the constitution came into force? It is very clear from the year 1950 January 26. So the particulars given in the graph in tabular form, that is it is the tabular form, years, decades one side, number of amendments other side. Question 32A. Increasing urbanization is not just about greater opportunity for people and economy, it also result in many problems. Comment. This is from chapter 7. Yes, I agree with the above statement. Urbanization has many problems. They are overcrowding, unemployment, slums and squatter, degradation of environment, health problems, transport problem, sewerage problems, water problems, trash problem, and many more problems will be there. To conclude, urbanization is not a problem itself, but unstable and unplanned urbanization is bound to create a social economic problem. These problems need to be countered in a planned and scientific manner, although they cannot be completely solved. Urbanization is good for the financial growth of a country, but careful planning is required to develop cities and other basic facilities. 32. War is always destructive. Comment. It is from chapter 13. Yes, I agree with the above statement. Both winner and loser of the war will be affected by war. They suffer regarding the destruction of economy and employment. Many casualties occur on both sides. Major part of GDP of both countries were spent on war. Many working age group people will die on both sides. Scarcity of food supplies also result in the war situation. Loss of property occurs on both sides. Price of the commodities rise for all over the world where war occurs. Hence, we can say war is always destructive. Question number 33A, India map. Group A, Group B. In Group A, 4 questions, Vindhya Range, Krishna River, Sikkim, Thar Desert. Group B, Aravali, Godavari River, Andaman Nicobar Islands, Tropic of Cancer. Now, first see Vindhya Range. This is the Vindhya Range. Krishna River, Sikkim, Thar Desert. This is the Thar Desert. This is Sikkim. Aravali Range. This is Vindhya Range. Vindhya Range. Now come to Group B. Aravalis, Godavari River, Andaman and Nicobar Islands, and Tropic of Cancer. These are the 8. Now come to world map. Locate the following in given outline map of the world. Group A, Bay of Bengal, Turkey, Australia, Germany. Group B, Indian Ocean, Nigeria, Vietnam, France. See here, Bay of Bengal. This area is Bay of Bengal. Turkey, this is the Turkey. Australia, a continent, the smallest continent, and Germany. So these are the four from group A. Now come to group B. Indian Ocean, Nigeria, Vietnam, and France. These are the former from world map. That is from 33B questions. I hope you are satisfied with my video. If you are satisfied, please like it. Share this video among your friends. If you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon, by which you will get my all videos in time. Thank you once again for watching this video.